Rod Serling.
You're traveling through another dimension. A dimension not only of sight and sound, but of mind. A journey into a wondrous land whose boundaries are those of imagination. Your next stop, the Twilight Zone.
So here is the agreement.
You got it all down?
Shh. Of course he did, Hans.
How are you feeling, Maria?
I think my baby is not coming tonight.
If we are all ready to sign...
Read it aloud.
We, the undersigned, having accepted the following propositions. A, that prior to the inception of language, man communicated by telepathic means. And B, that this ability still exists and can be developed to its former effectiveness, do hereby agree to the following. 1. To dedicate our lives to the study of mental telepathy and other extrasensory functions. 2. That the findings of this study will be applied not only to ourselves, but to our children, born and unborn.
Good, good.
3. That each family unit shall strive to avoid the interference of society. 4. That monthly correspondence shall be exchanged until such time as it is possible for all 4 units to establish a colony in which communication shall be exclusively mental. Comments?
More than sufficient, I think.
Carl?
It is what we agreed upon.
That sounds very close to disapproval.
No, I will sign.
You're certain? This must be entered into with absolute assurance.
He is assured, Holger.
You are still uncertain?
Not of the general concept. Yet I wonder, have we the right to impose this study on our children? Even those unborn?
Impose, Maria? You speak as though we harm our children. Is it not rather that we bestow upon them a great gift?
Of course, that is our hope. But we offer them no choice in the matter. Is that just?
I am also a mother, Maria, devoted to the welfare of my child. Yet I am convinced it is just.
It is more than just. It is inevitable. Destiny demands it. That's why I will be the first to sign.
And I, beneath my husband's signature.
I have no hesitation.
Nor have I, Professor Werner. Have you and Holger decided definitely not to remain in Heidelberg?
There's a house in Pennsylvania which was left to him by an uncle.
And what is the town?
It is called German Corners.
Ah.
It's for the better, Maria. You'll see.
Yes. Yes, all right.
Thank you.
Und my signature?
Thank you all.
It is a nice town, is it?
Oh, yes. Small, secluded. Ilse needs to be fed again. Excuse me, I must see to her.
What you have just witnessed is the curtain raiser to a most extraordinary play. To wit, the signing of a pact. The play itself will be performed almost entirely off stage. The main character of these final scenes lies sleeping in her crib, unaware of the singular drama in which she is to be involved. Her name is Ilse, the daughter of Professor and Mrs. Nielsen. Her age, barely 1. But 10 years from this moment, Ilse Nielsen will know the terror of living simultaneously in this world and in the Twilight Zone.
And now, The Twilight Zone, and our story, Mute, starring Wade Williams, with Stacy Keach as your narrator.
Sheriff?
Yeah?
This is Tom Poulter. The Nielsen house is burning.
What?
There's a fire at the Nielsen house, a big one. Hurry!
Right away.
Harry, what?
Max, Harry, I know it's 2 o'clock in the morning. There's a fire at the Nielsen house. Call the volunteers and get the truck out. I'll be there as soon as I can.
Oh, it's so far.
I told them when they first came here it wasn't a good idea to live that far from town, but no, they wouldn't listen. We want privacy, they said. Well, that privacy may very well be the end of them.
The girl, that lovely girl.
Thank you.
We can try.
Never mind the house. Keep the woods from catching.
You heard him, Tom.
Get the hose. Start pumping.
Right. Here goes.
Let's check the back.
There's no way in. They're done for.
That poor kid.
Harry! Over here!
Where'd you find her?
In the clearing. The sparks were about to catch. You think she's...
Let me see.
She burned?
No. She's alive. You all right?
She's in shock, Harry.
I'll put her in the car.
Lay her down on the seat.
There's a blanket in the back.
Here you go, little lady. Put this around you. It's going to be all right now.
Bad off. Can't talk, nor cry, nor nothing.
She isn't burned, though. Tell me something, Tom. How could she get out of that house without being burned? I'm fine.
Is she hurt?
Not physically. I think she's in shock. We better put her to bed.
Where are you going?
We'll have to use Sally's... the other bedroom. Cora?
All right, Harry.
Pull back the bedclothes.
Of course.
Cover her up. I'll be downstairs.
Poor darling. She looks a little like Sally, doesn't she? Harry? You want something to eat?
No, I gotta get right back. Thought I'd take a thermos of coffee for the boys.
Are her parents?
No, we have known. We haven't been able to get into the house yet. It's burning too hard.
But she...
Tom Poulter found her outside.
Outside?
We don't know how she got there. I expect her folks didn't get out, though. It's an awful fire.
Oh, the poor child.
Something's wrong with her. I know she isn't deaf or dumb or retarded or anything, but before she fell asleep in the car, I tried to get her to talk. She never said a word. Not a word. Even in shock, the power of speech isn't completely gone. It's as if she doesn't know how to talk.
Oh, Harry.
You know something, Cora? I don't think her parents ever taught her.
Mother. 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 Where are you, Mother? Ilsa. Ilsa. Are you near me, Father?
Ilsa. Ilsa, you must be brave now.
Mother! Mother! Where are you?
Over here, Harry. The other room.
Oh, my God. Both of them.
What is it, Ilsa? Oh, darling, what is it? I'm not gonna hurt you. Ilsa, what's the matter?
They're dead. They're dead. They're dead. They're dead.
You still awake, Cora?
Is the fire out?
Yes, it's out.
And her parents?
Too late.
How did it start?
We're not positive, but apparently the professor was smoking his pipe in bed, fell asleep.
And there was nothing left to...
Everything was burned, Cora, I told you.
There's no way of getting in touch with Ilsa's relatives, then.
Tom Poulter says the post office gets 3 letters for the Nielsens from Europe at the end of every month. But wait till the next batch arrives and write to the 3 addresses.
What are we going to do with the girl until then?
We'll have to keep her here. It'll only be a week or so, Cora, unless the girl can tell us something.
I doubt that she can.
You don't think she can talk either?
I tried everything I could to get her to, but...
That explains it.
What?
Those times Miss Frank and I tried to talk the Nielsens into putting the girl in school, the answer was always no. Now I know why.
Maybe there is something physically wrong with her.
The Nielsens would have told us if there was, Cora.
Not if they wanted to keep it a secret.
We can have Doc Steiger check her over, but I don't think he'll find anything.
But they were educated people, Harry.
They were strange people, too, Cora. Hardly spoke a word themselves. As if they were too good to bother talking to us. It might not be a bad idea to put her into school while we're waiting for those letters. Teach her how to talk, at least.
Not right away.
No. No, please.
Why not? She's got to learn sooner or later, doesn't she?
She just lost her parents, Harry.
I didn't mean tomorrow or the next day.
I don't understand their words.
It's a crime, though. A girl her age, not being educated, not even knowing how to talk.
Make them stop.
Her father, a professor, too, keeping his own child in ignorance. Well, something has to be done about it.
She needs time, Harry. She's been through such an awful ordeal. She's only a child.
Mother. Father. People. Here. I can't understand what they're saying. They speak in loud noises. Not the way we do. Please. Make them stop.
Well, at least she likes my cooking, especially at breakfast.
Of course she does. She's a growing child.
Do you think she likes us?
She's calm when you're around. In fact, she hardly ever leaves your side. The doctor says she's healthy. I don't understand it. If there was something organically wrong with her...
Don't talk. Please. Don't make those sounds anymore.
There's nothing wrong with her. He checked everything. There isn't a reason in the world why she shouldn't be able to talk. I'm sure she will, when she's ready.
Then I'm afraid we got a problem on our hands. She can't just learn on her own. I told you when she first moved here...
Speak gently, Harry. You're frightening her.
That's ridiculous. She has nothing to be frightened of here.
Think of how it must seem from her point of view.
If she's going to live among normal people, she'll have to...
But she is normal, except for the...
She's not. God.
Stop!
Oh, Harry, what did they do to her?
Ilsa!
Cora, leave her be.
I can't just...
She's been with us over a week now. What's the use? There's no way of getting through to her.
I have to keep trying, Harry. Ilsa? May I come in? Can't you tell me what... Oh, there. Go ahead and hold on to me. Oh, sweetheart, didn't they ever talk to you? Try to speak, Ilsa, try. Say your name at least. Can you do that? Ilsa. If only I could make you understand. Take away your fear. Look into my eyes. That's it. I'm trying to tell you something. Did you know I had a little girl once? This was her room. Her name was Sally. And then one day, one terrible day, I was downstairs. I looked out the kitchen window and I saw them coming, carrying something in their arms. What? What? Is that you, Tom? And Max? What do you have there?
I'm terribly sorry, Mrs. Wheeler.
What is that in the blanket?
Go on inside, Cora.
Why are you bringing it in here? Where's Sally?
She was swimming in the lake and...
No, she wasn't. She's home, I tell you.
Maybe you better sit down, ma'am.
Sally? Sorry. I can't help but think of it sometimes. But now... You look so much like her. It's almost like you understand. Do you, Ilsa? Do you?
Hello. Yeah. Okay, well, I'll be right over.
Who was that?
Tom at the post office. The three letters came in.
Oh.
Be back in a while.
Yes. Yes, you do that. Oh, hello, Ilsa. Sit down here with me, just the two of us. I'll have another cup of coffee. Did you hear that? The letters came from your people. I suppose that means you'll be leaving us, but that won't be for a few weeks, at least. For now, you can still be a part of our family.
Yes. Tom will come and take me to where there are other children like me.
Perfect, Ilsa. You're just about the best helper a person could have. Harry?
Everything all right?
Well, why wouldn't it be? Ilsa was just helping me dry the dishes. Do you have them?
What?
The letters. You said you were...
Oh, we can't have the letters, Cora. It's against the law. Tom's got to send them back. All he could let me do is copy the return addresses.
Oh.
I'm going to... Oh, hello, Ilsa. You like to stare, don't you?
Go in the living room, Ilsa. I'll be with you in a minute.
Give me some paper and envelopes, will you, please?
I suppose you have to write them.
What do you mean?
Nothing. Would you like a cup of coffee?
Thanks.
What are you telling them?
Oh, just about the fire, the Nielsen's dying. Asking them if they're related to the girl or... know where any of her relatives are.
What if...
Hmm?
What if her relatives don't do any better with her than her parents did?
It's none of our business, Cora.
The welfare of a child is everybody's business.
We're not in a position to decide for her.
No, of course not. Our position is to send her away, get rid of her. And maybe she'll never talk, Harry. Maybe she'll be terrified of shadows all her life.
Cora, I know how you feel. Sally's gone. Another child in the house. But she's not our child, Cora. We have no rights where she's concerned. And there is something wrong with her.
Is that why you want to get rid of her?
I think you know better than that. I'll finish these letters and put them in the mailbox before I leave.
Hi there, Cora.
Oh, hello, Eunice.
How's the little girl these days?
Fine, just fine. I was just checking for the mail.
Has it come yet?
I don't think so.
Looks like you got something.
Just some junk mail from yesterday. It was still in a box.
Well, you take care, Cora. Don't be such a stranger.
You too. Elkenberg. Calder, Werner, all from Germany. Strange. If I tear up the letters, he'll find the pieces. I must burn them. The furnace. That's it. In the basement. I must...
Where is she going? What's downstairs? No. No! She's going to burn them. She can't. Fire. Fire.
Ilsa, is that you? Ilsa, come back! Ilsa! Ilsa!
They'll never find me now. Never. Never. I'm here. My name is Ilsa Nielsen. Help me, please. Someone. I'm here. Hear her.
Now, who would that be?
Probably Miss Frank.
Miss Frank? What does she want?
I asked her to stop by.
Harry?
Aren't you going to let her in?
Oh, Harry, what have you done?
Mrs. Wheeler?
Hello, Miss Frank.
Is Ilsa here?
Won't you come in?
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Miss Frank.
Sheriff.
Glad you could come.
I felt it was my duty.
Please, sit down.
You haven't heard from her family, I take it.
Like I explained to you the other day, I wrote to these people in Europe 4 or 5 weeks ago, but we haven't gotten an answer. We don't know exactly what we're going to do with the girl, but until we decide, I feel she ought to start getting some education.
She most certainly should. It was positively criminal of her parents not to have started her education years ago. The smugness of them. In many ways, that fire may have been the blessing of her life.
Miss Frank!
I'm not just referring to her lack of education, Mrs. Wheeler.
But to call the hideous death of Ilsa's parents a blessing.
I'm sure I didn't mean it that way, Mrs. Wheeler.
What do you mean?
I'd rather not discuss it at this time, Sheriff, except to say that I believe I know why Ilsa doesn't speak.
You know?
And how very much she needs to be educated.
Why doesn't she speak?
I can't go into details right now. I shall at a later time, after I've had the opportunity to question her.
Question?
The first thing she must do, of course, is to learn to talk. If I may see her now.
She's upstairs resting.
I'll get her. Elsa? Elsa?
Don't let them put me in school. Please.
Elsa?
Please. They don't understand. They don't understand.
Harry.
What is it?
I'd like to talk to you before.
Cora, if it's about the girl going to school...
Harry, please.
We waited long enough. Those people aren't going to answer.
No, Harry.
What do you mean, no? Why shouldn't she?
I don't know. It's just that...
She starts tomorrow.
She'll be so frightened.
All right, she'll be frightened. A day, maybe 2 days, but she'll get over it. She'll start to learn.
She isn't ignorant. I swear she understands me sometimes without talking.
Elsa? Come here.
Come, dear. Hold my hand.
Ah, there she is.
She's very shy, Miss Frank. She'll need understanding.
And she shall receive it. Come here, Ilsa.
Go on. Shake her hand. Her name is Miss Frank.
I won't. I know what she's thinking. I can hear her mind.
I said, come here, child.
Don't touch me.
Go on.
There. See? I don't bite. I think we're going to get along just fine, you and I.
Not her. Not her.
Don't be worried, sweetheart. They're only children, like yourself. Wait for me and I'll come get you after school. Here we are. It's the first classroom. Ready? It won't be so bad. You'll see. Miss Frank?
Good morning, Mrs. Wheeler. We were just about to start.
I do hope everything will be all right. Ilsa's very shy.
She'll feel right at home in no time.
Shouldn't I stay with her a little while?
As long as you're here, she can't begin to adjust. Believe me, it's the only way.
Yes, well, goodbye, dear.
Don't leave me.
We'll take good care of her.
Remember, I'll meet you after school.
Now, let's introduce you to everyone. Class, this is Ilsa Nielsen. We're going to have to be very patient with her, because her parents never taught her how to speak. Not one word of English. We'll help her to learn, though. We'll work with her until she's just like everyone else. Now, Ilsa, can you say your name? Ilsa Nielsen. Try to say it, child. Your name, Ilsa. Ilsa. Try to say it, child. Ilsa.
Take your hand off my arm. You're hurting me.
Try to say it. A little later, then. We have plenty of time. You'll learn. I promise you, you'll learn. Open your books, class. Richard, will you read from the top of page 17, please?
This is a boat. A boat sails on the ocean.
Ocean?
He's trying to tell about the boat in the picture. But the boat isn't words. It isn't. Why don't they learn the way Father taught me?
Ilsa, look at this picture. See how it moves. Hear it on the water.
Ilsa, you must pay attention. Get up. I said get up. Now, we'll try again. Say your name, Ilsa. Your name. Do you understand? Your name is Ilsa. Ilsa!
Stop poking me!
Tell her what her name is, class. On the count of three. One, two, three. Ilsa! Ilsa!
Ilsa! Ilsa! Ilsa!
That's all for today, children. Don't forget your homework. Wait. Ilsa, I want to talk to you. I want you to know that you're not fooling me. I know exactly what you are. I know because my father tried to make me into the same thing when I was your age. But I was able to overcome the sickness he forced on me. As I'm going to help you overcome it, Ilsa. They were trying to make you into a medium. To distort your innocent mind so that you could communicate with the dead.
What is she saying?
You've been trained to be a medium.
No!
Haven't you?
It isn't true! Not what they were training me for.
Oh, you understand me. You know what I'm thinking. That proves it. Don't you see? You've just proven it to me. You are a medium.
No, you're wrong.
Ilsa?
There you are. Mrs. Wheeler.
Was it very bad, Ilsa?
Not at all. She's coming along nicely.
Oh, I'm so glad.
We'll see her in the morning, then.
Yes. Goodbye, Miss Frick.
Goodbye.
For now. See you tomorrow, Ilsa. And the next day. 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 And the next day.
Ask someone, Werner.
Please, where might we find authority?
Authority?
Constable? The
sheriff?
Yeah, the sheriff.
Down one block on the other side. Can't miss it.
Thank you.
I feel so guilty, Carl.
What could we do? We simply could not get away sooner. We have our own responsibility to the project.
I know, but almost 6 months since we last heard from Holger and Fanny. You still think something has happened?
Why else would they fail to write?
I hope you are wrong. That lovely child.
Oh, such a talent. The progress with her has been phenomenal. It is as if she was born telepathic. I think that of all the children, she has the most potential.
Hello?
It's me, Cora.
Yes, dear, what is it?
The ones from Germany are here. Did you hear me?
Yes.
I'm gonna bring them to the house. We'll be over in a little while.
All right.
No. No.
If only we heard from you, but there was never a word. Under the circumstances, you can understand why we felt at liberty to start adoption proceedings.
We understand completely, Sheriff.
As I said, we received no letters.
I just don't understand it. Well, here we are.
Holger and Fanny dead. I still can't believe it. How horrible.
More horrible. It's the sort of Ilsa exposed to people who do not understand. Oh, pray heaven we are in time to save her.
Hello.
Cora, this is Professor and Mrs. Werner, my wife.
How do you do?
Mrs. Vila.
Cora, they say they never received those letters.
Oh, that's odd. Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
She burns those letters, Maria.
Yes, I know. How terribly she suffers.
You came a long way, Mrs. Werner.
Yes, we did.
Are we going to tell them?
Not unless we have to.
May we see Ilsa?
I'll be going to get her out of school in a little while.
School?
God in heaven, school.
Ilsa Nielsen, stand. Come forward. Face the class. What is your name? Class, we will do again what we've been doing for the past few weeks. Think of Ilsa's name. Don't say it aloud. Just think it. Ready now? 1, 2, 3.
Ilsa! 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 Ilsa!
Here they are.
Ilsa, this is Professor and Mrs. Werner.
Ilsa, you remember us?
Our children are the ones who are just like you in Germany.
You remember the Elkenbergs, the Calders, us, your father and your mother?
Heidelberg, 10 years ago. The telepathy project.
The Werners are from Germany, Ilsa. They were friends of your parents.
Think. Where is your mind, Ilsa? Your mind. Hear me, Ilsa.
My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa.
Ilsa, don't.
My name is Ilsa. My name is Ilsa.
Shh, shh, Ilsa. Don't cry. I'm with you. You can't take her from me. You can't.
Cora.
No. I won't let them. I love her, and she loves me. She needs me. You have no right. No right.
Look, I apologize for both my wife and myself. Well, we thought...
We understand.
Naturally, you would think that we had come to take Ilsa back with us, but as I've said, we have no legal power to demand her, being no relation. Auf Wiedersehen, Sheriff.
Goodbye. Your bus should be here in about 5-10 minutes. Good luck. And thanks again.
I hope we did not make a mistake, letting them keep her here. Even though we do have the legal right to take her...
I don't think so, Carl. To take her to the other children now. The talent is gone.
I suppose. All those years Holger and Fanny spent on her, wasted.
Wasted, Carl? If they had not made her mind so receptive, how could they have directed her out of the burning house, even though they themselves were trapped?
Ah, but the loss, it isn't right.
There is no right or wrong in it, Carl. They all meant well. No one wanted to do anything but help her.
But to lose everything?
She has not lost everything. Why do you think I ask for you to let her stay here? Because she has gained something. We always knew that Holger and Fanny did not really care for her.
Maria!
Oh, they were not unkind. But the project always came first. You know that, Carl. To them, Ilsa was less a daughter than an experiment in flesh. She is going to be all right. Now she is loved. And that is so much more important than telepathy. Isn't it, mein Professor?
Ja, Liebchen. Much more important.
This has been the story of a girl named Ilsa Nielsen, soon to be Ilsa Wheeler, who lives in the town of German Corners, Pennsylvania. She discovered that in the world of nightmares, those which threaten physically are of little consequence when compared to those of the mind. And Ilsa's mind is now possessed by the most valuable talent of all, the capacity to love. From now on, the consuming flames that haunted her dreams will be confined exclusively to the Twilight Zone.
Mute, starring Wade Williams with Stacey Keach as your narrator, was adapted for radio by Dennis Etchison and written for The Twilight Zone by Richard Matheson. Heard in the cast were Amanda Amari, Deb Dotzer, Linda Ryder, Craig Brawley, Valerie Glowinski, Jamie Barron, Richard Shavzin, and CJ Amari. The producers of The Twilight Zone wish to thank CBS Enterprises, Carol Serling, Dennis Etchison, Dick Brescia Associates, Claire Simon Casting, Terry Jennings, XM Satellite Radio, Sirius Satellite Radio, our sponsors and our radio affiliates for helping make this series possible. This radio series is produced and directed by Carl Amari for Falcon Picture Group.